Hey, comic book fans, my nerdy friends, my geeky compadres, what's going on? Welcome to another Trading with RWC, where I review trades that I've read for you guys. This one isn't really a trade, it's just kind of a thicker book, single issue. But I've been meaning to read it for a while now, and had the time, so I thought I'd do it, and then do a review for you guys. So this is Spawn and Batman. Just an image book done by Frank Miller and Tom McFarlane. Okay, so this book is weird. done. no, just kind of really strange. The art is weird to me because it's Batman drawn by McFarlane. So he looks kind of darker than usual, like more evil. Which is fine, you know, whatever. But to begin with, Batman kind of comes across this arm from, you don't really see, you see like the aftermath of this big fight that he had, regarding like some arms deal, it looked like, and he comes upon this, cybernetic glove. While he's checking it out, a cyborg comes and attacks him, starts beating the crap out of him. He realizes that there's actually a person in there, tries to free him from the robot exoskeleton, and comes out with only a head. Pretty crazy. He takes the head with him back to the Batcave. Has a pretty humorous exchange with Alfred about patching him up and stuff like that, and does a dental, checks the dental files of this head to figure out who he is, finds out he's some bum from New York, and travels to New York to find out what's going on. Once he gets to New York, he's, you know, like, in the alleys and looking, listening to all the bums and stuff, and comes upon Spawn. And there he is, there's Spawn. The rest of the book is pretty much this big, huge, gigantic fight between Batman and Spawn. For real, more than half the book is just them going at each other. With this background story going on of the cyborgs and stuff, ends up being this girl who just won, like, this humanitarian award. I forget her name. Margaret Love is her name, that's it. She won this humanitarian award for what she does with homeless shelters. But what she does with the homeless shelters is she takes the homeless and implants them in cybernetic bodies, and they become weapons. While Spawn and Batman are beating the hell out of each other, she's having this gathering of the rich and famous and everything on her boat, and she gives everybody some punch. Non-alcoholic, but loosens up the mind and makes them susceptible to ideas. She starts explaining to people that, you know, she has this arsenal, and how people ruin everything, and how she's gonna fix that. She has nuclear bombs and missiles and stuff. And Batman and Spawn team up to take her down. But with her last breath and will, she pushes this button on an amulet and releases a nuclear missile headed for the heart of New York City. Spawn uses his magic to have Batman and himself transported to the missile. Batman uses his skilled senses and steady hands to, you know, make the missile miss its target. Then after they save the day, they pretty much tell each other to F off, and that there will be another time when they beat each other up, and that's the end. Pretty crazy, like I said. I'm not a huge McFarlane fan. I did like this. At the end, Batman threw this batarang and hit Spawn in the face. I thought that was kind of funny. I like McFarlane when he does Spawn, but the way he draws Batman is really weird to me. I don't know. It was kind of neat, though. Real quick read. Neat. I don't think I'll, like, reread it a million times, but I might reread it again. It was fun just to read. But, yeah, the artwork on Batman was just kind of strange. And Alfred looked really weird. But other than that, it was enjoyable. Enjoyable enough. So if you ever find it for insanely cheap, go ahead and pick it up. It's worth it just to see Batman and Spawn together. Yeah, it was all right. So, check it out. I'll talk to you later. Bye.